How you doing, fans? And welcome back to Glacier Games. As you can see, our next matchup coming up, it will be the submission match for the New Generation Championship between Angus and Jason Storm. When they make it through that, then they will go into a ladder match. Unless it is a two-match sweep, then if we have to go to the tiebreaker, the last match will be a KO matchup. This is a three stages of hell between Angus and Jason Storm, the current New Generation Champion and the former New Generation Champion. Here comes the current New Generation Champion now, Angus. Fans, a lot of people in the back in our locker room are completely creeped out by this guy. They have no idea how to react to a guy like this. They have no idea how to treat a guy like this. They're just completely in shock, awe, and amazement, complete dumbfounded. So, of course, the Creep Angus wins the New Generation Championship at Gold Rush. He chose to take his winner take all and cash in on the winner, on the New Generation Champion. Thus, that is why he walked out of Gold Rush as the New Generation Champion. And a lot of people may not like it, but he did beat Jason Storm fair and square. However, Jason Storm had just got out of a six-man battle royal to win that championship. And then Angus comes in, making him defend it? Man, that's bullshit. But anyways, Angus is your New Generation Champion. Now, Jason Storm gets his one-on-one rematch with Angus for the New Generation Championship. This time in a three stages of hell match. It's no secret, Jason Storm begged for a three stages of hell. He said that he said beating Angus to take his championship back wasn't good enough. Beating him is one. Taking his championship back is two. And he has said openly that he hopes and prays that this match goes to the third, just so he can knock out Angus. Wow. This rivalry built up, not even in front of the camera. That's how fast it built between these two men. Angus cashing in on Jason Storm, and Jason Storm thought he was rightfully so the New Generation Champion. He felt he had paid his dues. He felt that he had done everything that he had needed to do before winning a championship, then waiting his time, being patient, winning the championship, then losing it not 10 minutes later to Angus. Wow. He's looking for redemption here tonight, fans. He's just looking for somehow to come out with this championship. Like I said, fans, the first match will be a submission match. The second match will be a ladder match. And if for some reason this match does go to the third fall, it will be a knockout match. KO is the only way to beat your opponent in the final match. And that's what it's all about, fans. The New Generation Championship here in NCW. The NCW New Generation Championship. Most people who have held the New Generation title have gone on to win the World Championship. That is a statistical fact here in Nightmare Championship Wrestling. And that belt, some would say, means more than most things do. Here in the most accolades, rather. Here in Nightmare Championship Wrestling. But here we go. Beautiful. Oh, nice. Russian leg sweep to start the match out with. These guys are just going to feel each other out. Because remember, last time they fought, one was completely spent and one was completely unexhausted. Now, both men are not tired at all. So we're going to see what two fresh superstars. Oh, nice. And going straight to his patented lightning kicks. Straight to the chest. Follows it up. Oh, he was going to slap his opponent there. Oh, he kicks him. Puts him right back in the corner. Angus gets a reversal. And another reversal by Jason Storm. Angus gets a reversal from him. And another reversal by Jason Storm. These guys, oh, Jason Storm taunting now, telling him to use his head. And what's going on? Look out, big knee, putting his opponent back into the corner, and more rapid kicks right to the chest. Look out, oh, and a running boot right to the face of the Creep, Angus. And look out, Angus. Oh, Angus had control as a rake to the eyes. And look out, another reversal by Jason Storm. These two are going at it. And a lockup. Collar and elbow tie up. Who will get it? Yes, wrist lock there. Out of it. Into a twisting. Oh, nice. Spin reverse neck breaker there by Jason Storm. And Angus looks like he could have been in trouble there. But Angus is still getting up fairly fast. Still holding his own. And oh no, look out. Oh, has his chin cupped and just multiple chops right across the chest. Oh man, well, it looked like 10 of them and he falls straight off in a dead man style. Look out, big time flying, flying headbutt to the back of Angus. Angus, another rake to the eyes of his opponent. And he has the... Oh, man, he had the back of his opponent's neck, and he just torques those knees, throwing him right over those steel steps. And now Angus coming off the top with a senton to no avail. Oh, nice. Reversal there. And look out. Oh, nice, and a head kick right to the head. Nice move there by Jason Storm. Jason Storm has his opponent. Oh, man, and now he makes his opponent eat the... steel steps right to the kneecaps. Nice. Follows it up with a leg drop right to the groin. Digging his heels into the groin of his opponent. Oh, nice. And outside the ring, it looks like he is going for his submission maneuver there. He calls that the Koji Clutch. Wow. Koji Clutch locked in over there in the corner as he stares at the barricade, but to no avail because he can't... Oh, man! He can't finish it outside the ring, but it doesn't matter. He still... makes him eat that Eye of the Storm. Wow. Eye of the Storm on the outside on the concrete. Oh, and follows it up with a moon stomp. Wow, Jason Storm is just all over Angus. Angus trying to fight back for what he can. And nice, following it up with a tiger suplex. Wow, Jason Storm is all over Angus. Angus just has, oh man, and now choking the life out of his opponent. Angus trying to fight back. Oh man, he's caught him in the ring again. Yet another Koji Clutch. And this time he's cranking. Oh, he's cranking heavily on that thing. Oh, he's cranking and he let go. Wow, he let it go. He went for an Eye of the Storm and a reversal. And oh, it could have been Shades of the Championship match. The last match these two had, but no, a reversal, and now he's calling for something else. Look out. What's he do? He spins him around. Nice! An Eye of the Storm. The second Eye of the Storm of the match. Wow. And I can't believe it, but Jason Storm is all over Angus. And remember, Jason Storm is the son of former world champion Flip, the winner of the first ever Elimination Chamber in car wrestling. And he's trying to make Dad proud now as he's taking on Angus. And oh man, look out. More rapid kicks to the chest. This guy's got a game plan and he's definitely sticking to it. Oh nice, and a running boot to the face to follow up. Drags him away from the corner now. Does Jason Storm. And look out, Jason Storm looks like he could have been going for something, but no. A reversal into, nice, an airplane spin. A patented maneuver there by Angus. And Angus following it up with another patented maneuver there. Headbutts. Oh, man, nice. To the head of his opponent. He could be careful. He could break his mask by doing that. Wow. Look out. Catches his opponent as he enters the ring, turns him around, throws him on the ropes. Oh, he went for a kick to the midsection there, but didn't nail it. Reversal into a Russian leg sweep. Beautiful reversal there. And it looks like, what's he going for? He turns him around. Nice! A third Eye of the Storm. Telling him to use his head. Wow. And yet, puts him in what looks like the camel clutch. Oh, man. Oh, he was trying to crawl away, but it looks like he let it go. And it's very dangerous to let go of moves like that. It's actually against the rules. But anyways. Oh, nice. And a head kick right to the head, telling him to use his head once again. And what could he be going for? Look out. Was going for moves? No. Would look like kicks. And now rear race lock by. Oh, nice. The creep Angus as he drops him with a sleeper slam. Tries to stomp and his opponent reverses and he gets back up. But he's followed up by another back slam. And Angus looks like he could be building up momentum. Angus trying to stomp his opponent once more, but to no avail. Look out. Oh, nice. Into the neck breaker. That backbreaker, neck breaker combo. And now booting his opponent while he's down. Kicking him right in that mask. Oh, he ate it that time. Wow, just saw the head snap back on that. Oh, no. Oh, man. And he locks him up for yet another Koji clutch. Oh, man. And he taps immediately. And just like that, the winner of the first match in this Three Stages of Hell is Jason Storm. And nicely done as he slides out of the ring. And now this ladder match begins for the New Generation Championship. Angus is back up, setting up the ladder. Oh, man. Oh, and a drop kick as his face hits right into the ladder there. And it looks like Jason Storm, not wasting any time, trying to fight off the creep, Angus. And look out, the ladder set up. Oh, rear waist lock as Angus gets back up. Nice sleeper slam there to knock his opponent down. And these two in a collar and elbow tie up, fighting back and forth. Rear waist lock follows it around by grabbing the head. He comes back. No, and a knee face buster there by Angus. Nice reversal. Oh, and he lets him fall as he climbs to the top. He looks like he could be going for something. No, a dive off the top. Oh, and he's caught. Oh, he was caught by Jason Storm into that backbreaker. Wow, what a maneuver there. I can't believe he got caught into that backbreaker. Jason Storm is so technically sound. He's just all over Angus, and Angus is more of a brawler. Into the ladder. He flips him off. Takes a run at him. Oh, nice, and a spear. Doesn't break the ladder, but he damn sure makes sure that the creep Angus knows it's there. Telling him to use his head once more. Oh, man. He has been all over Angus from the beginning of this Three Stages of Hell. I haven't seen not one point except for the airplane spin. That was the only time that I saw Angus in somewhat of control. And look out. A ladder grapple dropping that ladder right to the back of his opponent. Setting it up now in the corner is Jason Storm. And now Jason Storm and Angus going back and forth. He throws him what looks like he was trying to throw him into the corner, but he misses. And now, nice power slam there. That could be a chance. That's an opening for Angus. Angus throws his opponent into the ladder. Oh, nice. An electric chair drop to follow up on Jason Storm. Jason Storm and Angus, look out! Jason Storm catches Angus with that spine buster. Beautiful spine buster there. And now throws him into the corner, into the wedged ladder. Look out. Oh, man! Just scoop slamming him right into it. That could have tore an ACL the way he landed. And it looks like he could be calling for the Eye of the Storm. He could be called Eye of the Storm, just like that, right there. This Three Stages of Hell may not even make it to the third stage. And Jason Storm is climbing. Wait a minute, out of the crowd. That's Hunter Thames, the People's Champion, as Jason Storm is trying to win this matchup. Wait a minute, Jason Storm. He falls from the ladder and Hunter Thames, oh my God, Hunter Thames is here to help the creep Angus. And he picks him up. Face plant to Jason Storm. Jason Storm is down. This is bullshit. I cannot believe this. Angus is at the top of the ladder trying to pull down his championship to take it to the third. And look out. Yeah. Oh, I can't believe this. And he drops him with a suplex. And Angus has pulled down his championship. Hunter Thames has completely interrupted this matchup. This match is going to the third fall. Fuck this. I'm making an executive decision. This is no bullshit. The next person who comes out and interrupts this match will be fucking fired. We are going to the third fall, but no one will interfere in this matchup. I will not tolerate this at all. This match will go to the third fall, but if anyone comes out, they will be fired if they attempt to interfere in this New Generation Championship match. And now, both of the challengers back up, taking it to the third. I can't believe that Hunter Thames would stoop so low. Look at Eye of the Storm, off gate, and Eye of the Storm straight into it. And this KO match could be started off. I can't believe that this match is going to the knockout. This is the only way you can win this matchup is by knockout. And look out. Look out. He looks like he's going to the top. No, Angus catches him and throws him right off. Angus goes to the top now. Coming off with a splash. He gets caught with yet another backbreaker there. And he kicks him right in that mask. Oh, man. I think I've heard that mask snap a couple times tonight. It could be close to breaking. Oh, man. Especially when moves like that, risking his own safety. And look at, oh man, he catches him. Oh my goodness, I can't believe it. The first daydream of the match. And Jason Storm is down. Angus, walking around now, getting a chair. Look out, what could he be going for? He swings, oh, he looks like he got a piece of it, but not everything. Look out, oh no, these two battling, swinging that chair profusely back and forth. Oh, and it looks like Jason Storms is the one to eat that chair shot. Oh no, the creep Angus. He now has the bell. What could be he going for? No, reversal. Look out. Oh, and he nails him in the face with the bell. Oh, and he cracks him again with the bell. Oh man, he is just going to town with that bell now. And a nail to the back of the head. Wow. What a matchup. This match, it won't take long for this knockout to happen if these two keep fighting with weapons. And now a collar and elbow tie up in front of your screen, as you can see, right beside my announce table. Oh, nice, right to the eyes. And look out, he's got the back of the head of Angus. Does Jason Storm. Jason Storm throws him back in the ring and now choking his opponent. What could be happening? Jason Storm slides in and out of the ring yet again. He gets a chair. Throws the chair in the ring as Angus now has the chair. He's tearing up the announce table. Wow. These two look like, what are they going for? He turns around. Oh my God. Is that it? That's it. That one ring bell shot breaks his mask. Wow. I can't believe it. The championship, just like that, goes right back to Jason Storm. The former champion becomes the current champion. Jason Storm walks out of here as the New Generation Champion once again. Wow. The only person to ever reclaim their championship after the winner take all has cashed in on them and taken their championship. I cannot believe that he makes history here tonight. Jason Storm. Wow. And fans, coming up next, we have the Money in the Bank on a defense here tonight inside a Hell in a Cell. That's right. The Black Stallion, Mark Sanson, will defend his Money in the Bank against Robin Storm, the Swedish Warrior. We will find out here tonight who will walk out as Mr. Money in the Bank. Usually we have the Money in the Bank match here at Glacier Games, whereas we did it at Steps to Glory this year. So, without any further ado, here comes Robin Storm, the Swedish Warrior, the Hall of Famer. He is a death-defying athlete, to say the least. And then when he catches you with that sound of sweet, that beautiful, the most perfect super kick in car wrestling today, you will go to sleep. And, you know, Robin Storm is a Hall of Famer here. I can't believe that, you know, well, actually, I can't believe it. I made this match earlier tonight. Instead of the Hell in a Cell being Seven Sins, I made the Money in the Bank defend his Money in the Bank inside. And as you can see, his beautiful new Money in the Bank Championship. That's right. The Money in the Bank will now be held not as a briefcase, but as a belt. That beautiful, bright green Money in the Bank Championship that you see Mr. Money in the Bank carrying right there. Yes, it is. The Black Stallion, Mark Sampson, Mr. Money in the Bank, presenting his new Money in the Bank Championship. That's right, fans. Money in the Bank is now a belt, not a briefcase. It doesn't change the rules to it at all. You can still cash the belt in on the world champion only. And, you know, it's just to give you guys a little something different to look at. I got tired of looking at the briefcase. I wanted a belt. And so, and as a matter of fact, the winner-take-all belt is being made as we speak. But this is the debut of the Money in the Bank belt, which he is defending here in this matchup tonight. And this matchup, as we all know it, is the Money in the Bank Hell in a Cell. We always do a Hell in a Cell at Glacier Games, so why not have the Money in the Bank defend his Money in the Bank in the Hell in a Cell? And two awesome, awesome competitors here tonight in the Hell in a Cell. You have former world champion, current Mr. Money in the Bank. He was also in the first Elimination Chamber, the Black Stallion, Mark Sampson, versus Hall of Famer, former world champion, Robin Storm. Now, Robin Storm and Mark Sampson, no strangers to each other, both TXW originals, as they're getting this matchup started, just with high velocity. Look out, nice enziguri there by Robin Storm. And Robin Storm, oh, looks like he could have been taunting in Mark Sampson's face, and the Black Stallion not going to take that from the Swedish Warrior. Like I said, I've known these two for a long-ass time, and both of them I started out in TXW with. Both of them were main eventers when I met them. Now, they're still main eventers till this day. Oh, nice! Spinning just discus forearm right into the face. Followed up that stomp to the chest. And more stomps by the Swedish Warrior. Look out. Ooh, nice springboard attack there by Robin Storm. Robin Storm goes to the top rope. Look out, comes off the top. Ooh, he looked like he was going with a frog splash, but does not nail it. And a reversal. And Robin Storm and Mark Sampson still going at it. Look out, hitting the ropes, coming back. Nice, catching an atomic drop into a drop kick. Nice maneuvers there by Robin Storm. Robin Storm still the more technical of the two, even after all these years. And Mark Sampson, still the flashier of the two, still going to go after them weapons before Robin Storm will. And Robin Storm, former, oh, nice, extreme champion, former high-flying champion. Mark Sampson, former world champion, former, look out. Barely missing that chair with that, what looked like neckbreaker cradle into a DDT, some sort of maneuver. That was beautiful. Now, setting Mark Sampson onto the top. Oh, Mark Sampson throws him. Oh, my goodness. He catches a Sound of Sweden as he comes off the top rope. And he goes for the pinfall here. One. No, not even a one count. Oh, my God. These two former world champions are now turning up the heat. I can't believe it. Wow. And look out, Mark Sampson now in control of Robin Storm. Oh, man, catches him with an old faceplant maneuver that he used to call the blackout, but now, no, it looks like he could be going for the real blackout. And he's sizing up Robin Storm. Wait a minute. Look behind Robin Storm, right behind his feet. No, not the blackout. Onto the chair. Oh, my God. What a maneuver there. One, two, and a kick out by Robin Storm. Oh my God, these guys are going at it already. I mean, these two, I don't know how these guys would make it a better match. I mean, I guess you could add me to the match. That's the only way I would think you would make it better. But anyways, not the point. Look out, spear. Oh man, and as his back hits onto the steel. And look out, he comes off the top with the axe handle. Nice moves there by Robin Storm. Beautiful choreography there. Look out. Throws him into the steel. Nice. Nailing him. Oh, wait a minute. The forearm shots into a powerbomb. Oh, and he comes through the cell. Oh my God, right in front of me here. These guys just, he just powerbombed him right through the cell. Now these guys are fighting right in front of me. Wow. This match is good. I'm wondering how good this match can get. And now into the ring. Oh man, he elbows him. And these two still battling in the ring is Mark Sampson and Robin Storm. Look out. Throws him back over the ropes. Hits the ropes, comes back. He doesn't hit anything. Now these two are both battling outside the ring. Mark Sampson nailing Robin Storm with shots. Throws him back in the ring. And look out, another elbow to the forehead of Robin Storm. And Mark Sampson looks like he wants to shake things up. Mark Sampson looking to take it to the top of the cell. Oh my God, Mark Sampson is on top of the cell. And he's patiently waiting. And he's just waiting on top of the cell for Robin Storm. Robin Storm is up now. And he's outside the cell. And now he's climbing the cell. These two men will meet at the top of the cell. We haven't seen a Hell in a Cell here in 5 years. Oh, and he looks like he was going for some sort of super kick. Sound of Sweden, but nothing. Oh, Sound of Sweden! Right there on top of the cell. Oh my God, Sound of Sweden on top of the cell. It looks like it poked a hole through the cell. And these two battling back and forth. Look out. He's got a hold of Robin Storm now. And it looks like a back suplex on top of the cell. Wow. These two are just battling it out. Wow. I can't believe it. And now what is he going for? Oh no. It looks like the Black Stallion Mark Sampson is sizing him up for a blackout. No, don't do it. Oh my God. Blackout through the top of the cell. Oh my goodness. Blackout through the top of the cell. One. No, not even a one count. Robin Storm will not die. Robin Storm with a shoulder block. And look out. He comes off the top rope. Oh, nice foot stomp there by Robin Storm. Robin Storm hitting him with that chair. And, well, it looks like he's backing off. What's he going for now? Big time shoulder block there to his opponent, Mark Sampson. And now he's backing off to the corner. And he's going for, well, I'll be right back, folks.
I go hard in the motherfucking paint, nigga. Fucking paint, nigga. Cast off the beast in me. It's underneath my skin.